my name's William. I am one of the board for You Can Be a Doctor. And today I'm going to talk about the University Clinical Aptitude Test, or the UCAT. This is an entrance exam that you need to sit to apply to some medical schools, and all five of the medical schools in Scotland use this exam. The exam is 2 hours long, takes place entirely on a computer, and consists of five sections testing different skills. The sections are verbal reasoning, decision making, quantitative reasoning, abstract reasoning, and situational judgment. Some of the questions that you'll see might appear strange at first because they're different to the questions that you would normally find in your school exams. But after a bit of practice, you should become really comfortable with flying through these questions. You have to pay to sit the exam, but there are bursaries available for some pupils, so it's worth checking on the website to see if you qualify for any of these reduced costs. The exam will be sat during the summer before you apply through UCAS, and it only lasts a year. So if you're having a gap year after high school, you should wait to sit this exam until the year of your application. We advise giving yourself a month of preparation time, so take this into account when you're booking your exam. Practicing questions is key to doing well in this exam, and that means that practice questions will be the mainstay of your preparation. The UCAT website has a couple hundred questions available for free that you can use for your practice, and there are many third parties that provide questions on the internet for candidates to use. There are also a multitude of third parties that provide paid question banks, and some of these can be of varying quality. It's important to know that while some candidates might swear by paid resources that they used, you can perform well in this exam using only resources that are freely available. In addition to your question banks, some candidates will use videos or written guides available on the internet, or they'll use physical books or preparation courses. You Can Be a Doctor have produced a free student handbook that discusses different tactics that you can use for the sections of the UCAT, and you can find that on our website. It also lists the many free resources that we think you'll find useful for your preparation. To make sure that your practice is as efficient as possible, it's important to not just batter through practice questions. You should plan your month of study so that you're covering all of the five sections and giving them as much attention as they require. Some sections will require different amounts of preparation, but that's something that you can work out as you go along. During your practice, look at the questions that you're getting wrong and record the types of questions that you seem to get wrong most often. You can then target these with your practice and come up with techniques that you can use to get faster with them, or just decide to skip them if they come up in your final exam. You could set yourself time trials to try and improve your speed, seeing how many questions you could do in 15 minutes. There are four mock tests available on the UCAT website, and these are a really important resource because they're the closest thing you can get to the final exam. To use them most strategically, we recommend saving them until the end so that you're really comfortable with the questions before you dive into a full 2 hour exam. And many candidates worry about what a good score is, and it's difficult to answer this question because it changes year on year. And it's important to know that the score that you obtain will only be compared to other candidates that have sat the exam that year. If you want to assess how well you're doing in your practice, you can use online guides to convert percentages correct into the scoring system that they use in the UCAT. These websites are linked on our website and in the handbook. If you find that you're consistently performing at or above average in your practice, this is very promising for the final exam. And finally, it's important for candidates to understand that each medical school will place different emphasis on your UCAT score when deciding on candidates. What this means is that after you get your final UCAT score, you should carefully look at the different medical schools you're applying to decide which ones are going to be most appropriate for your application.